Hello. We all like to celebrate life. We all like to celebrate birthdays. A lot goes into celebrating birthdays. Everybody likes to celebrate them. We all have one. That one special time of year where we want to plan a birthday party. But a lot goes into planning a birthday party. Not only does just planning a party and getting your loved ones together, it takes time, preparation. You gotta think about the food. What are you guys gonna eat? Where is it gonna be at? Is the date a good date for everybody? It takes a while to get there. First, what's the birthday? Who's the birthday for? Is it for you? Is it for somebody you love? A family member, child, spouse, anyone that you might care about? Then you gotta find out if their birthday is available for everybody. Like if it's during the week, should you have it on the weekend? Or is everybody available on a Sunday at 12? Or maybe like a dinner? You gotta figure out what works for everybody depending on everyone's schedule. Then you gotta think about if everybody can get there. Do they have cars? Do they need a carpool? Do they need to go with people? Do people need to pick them up? And then you gotta think about, do you want it on your birthday? Or do you want to have it after your birthday? You have to think about just the days that matter to you the most and what are available for everybody. Then you have to think about where you're going to have it at. Are you going to have it at home? Are you going to have it at a venue? Are you going to have it at a restaurant? You have to make a reservation. So you might want to think about that ahead of time because some places do have policies. Just it all depends on where you go and the number amount of people that want to come. Then you have to think about if that many people, they can house that many people. Like some restaurants can't house that many people, or some hotels, they have the little banquet areas, they have a certain amount, like a limit that you can bring of people. You have to figure that out. After you figure out the number of guests that you might be having and where you might be having it at, then you have to think about if you're going to have what you're going to have there as far as a theme. Now, a theme can go in as a color or a certain like figurine you might like, or maybe a character or a movie or just different things can be in a party, can be their theme. You gotta think about, how is it kids? Are kids gonna come to the party? If it's a adult party, or if it's gonna be a kids party? And to know what kind of theme to even safe around kids so kids can participate too. And then once you figure that out, then you'll know what the color scheme and what you might wear. So that goes into it too. If you want to match a party, and then you have to think about how much that's going to cost. Like balloons and tablecloths and napkins and silverware and cup and utensils and things to grab food with. And if they're gonna go with the party, some people like theirs to be decorative, some people just don't care and get plasticware. It just all depends really on what the person likes. Then after you figure out that amount, you need to figure out the food, because what we need things is for if you don't have food. So like, what kind of food? Are you gonna have a three course or like a buffet? Or are you going to get it catered, or are you going to cook it yourself, or have maybe somebody you know cook it? You just got to figure out really what is convenient for you and what your budget's like. And then you have to think about like a party part, like if you have like party platters and stuff like that, like them all take time too, because even with the food, you still need like little hand foods and like little sodas and things that people drink. Because people do get hungry before they eat. Because if it's a birthday party, that's what they're going to want to do. Eat. Eat your cake. Drink your sodas. So, then, after you think about the food, and after you're done cutting your cake, and you're having fun, everybody starts to leave, you got to think about cleaning up. Who's going to help you clean up? Who's going to be there afterwards to help carry extra food out, take down the decorations if it's in a hall, clean up the dishes, or just depending on really how you do your party, it's going to depend on how you clean up and how many people you might need. And then you just, then if you just ask for help, help does help go a long way. So, my advice after you do all that is just plan ahead. Because starting ahead, the further people get noticed, the further that they have to plan and to be able to be there. And then just having open-minded, because some people might come and you might bet on it, and some people might come, more people might come, so you never know. You just gotta be open-minded on what's gonna happen and how the turnout is, and that you can control it, that you've done your best. And then you gotta think about how you want it, how you dream you want it to be, and celebrate your goals. And that's how you plan a birthday party. Thanks.